Alright, today's video is not so much going to be on an edible plant. Hopefully the wind's not too bad. It is blowing here, so I've changed the direction I'm going to film from for this video. But today I want to go over a plant. It's called Velvetleaf. And as far as cordage, it is an awesome plant to know. But if you look at the leaves, they remind me, you see how they're heart-shaped? Got the split in the middle there. But if you look, see, if you, I don't know if you can see the reflection, but it has a velvety texture to the leaves, which is where it gets its name, velvet leaf. It's also called the pie crust plant. And that's because just before the flowers open up, the pod looks similar to, they say, a pie crust. To me, it looks like a green oversized anise. That's what it looks like to me. It may look different to you. But as far as cordage, this is a awesome plant to know. The flower is only about that big and it's nice and yellow. But this is the easiest way to tell it, is to look at the leaf. It's heart-shaped. You know, almost looks close to a miniature sunflower leaf, but it has a velvety texture to it. A lot of hairs on it. So does the stem. All right, but that's the easiest way to recognize this plant. It grows in disturbed areas, you know, areas that have been dug up. I drove around looking for a much taller plant than this one, because these will get up over 6 feet tall, and that's the ones to get for the cordage. You know, the longer the better, because you have longer strands in there. Now, in a disturbed area, the first year they'll go crazy, and then each subsequent year, you'll see less and less of them as other plants take over. Because it is an introduced plant. It is not native to the United States. Now, in India, and Chinese call it Chinese jute, but in India, they make rugs and stuff out of it. It is that strong of a cordage. All right, well, I'll be back in a minute. I'm going to go over and I'll show you how to split one of these down and make some cordage out of it.
This is one I picked last year. See how much longer this one is to dry it out. Because the best way to work with it is to dry it out before you attempt to work with it. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I just pull it right out of the ground. Cut the stem portion off. Alright. I'm splitting it. Alright. Now, what I do is I fold it backwards. Oops. Not cooperating with me. I'm going to get all the center pulp out. See that? Alright. In some cases, we can just peel it right off of there. Look at the length of the piece here. Alright. Now what I'll do is just, see there? Just kind of twist it in between my fingers like this. That breaks it all up. Now this is an extremely stiff cordage, strong cordage I should say. Now I'll take this. I made rope about two-thirds the thickness of my pinky, and it is more than strong enough to support my weight. What I do, see the length of my strand here? I will take about two-thirds length. One side's twice the length of the other. And then I will just start spinning. See that? Now we're getting our spin there. And eventually, it'll fold over on itself. And you just keep doing that. But you spin both sides the same. See how it's spinning through? The more fiber you add in there, the thicker that'll be. Now, You can do one side, then the other, and let it spin in. Or, the longer this gets, the easier that is. Now, the whole thing I want to show you, I got to get down to toward the end. I mean, look at, let's just keep adding, or keep twisting, and now, the less of that pith that's on there, the better. The easier it'll spin for you. Okay. Now, you can keep it out like this if you want a tighter spin. Alright. Now, this is the part I wanted to show you, okay? See how thin this section is getting here? So I want to add some more in. I'm going to take this piece here. Now, most of the stuff I've ever read says you just feed it in like this and start twisting. My concern is that when you put load on it, that can slip. So what I do is I will take, feed it over to the other side, and create a loop right up at my bottom twist. Tuck it right in there, like that. And then I will spin. And what happens, in doing so, I have fed in the next piece and locked it in, because now it folds over. And it's not so easy to slip out. You are going to be more likely to, oops, break the fibers than you are to slip it out, you know, have it slip on you. Now we're getting down to the bottom of this other side. And the thing is, you don't want, you want to keep those add-in points as far away from each other as possible. And what I will do, alright, just to give you an idea. Look at that. I'm cutting into my skin. Pulling on it. And look how thin that cordage is. That's maybe, I don't even think that's an eighth of an inch thick. Gives you an idea how strong. Okay. See how that twists off so nice. Now we twist until it turns in on itself. Now, I know I've seen some videos where they talk about double wefting and all that crap. That just seems awful labor intensive to me to get a small piece of cordage when you can do the same thing by just controlling the amount of fibers you put into it at any given time. The more fibers you start with, the thicker your rope will be. The thicker your rope is, the stronger it will be. So you can do the same thing. Come on, cooperate with me. Alright. Now, there's another way to do this. I mean, you can anchor this down if you want a nice pretty... See, by holding that tight the way I did, look how nice and even and straight those twists are. Alright? Just keep... I'm folding my nail back doing that. And you see how small that is. Alright? See if I can find something to compare it to. Well, that's right, my knife has a ruler on it. This piece here is way under an eighth. I don't even think it's a 16th. Looks like it is about 2 millimeters in thickness. And you see how strong that is. You could use that in a long enough piece for traps, any number of things. For tying things up. So remember, velvet leaf, if you see it, is a good plant for making cordage out of. And all you're looking for when you're wanting to make cordage is any plant that has a high fiber content. It doesn't necessarily have to be strong. Now, velvet leaf, you can actually use it in wet conditions without deteriorating. Whereas, like, if you're using, you can make it out of the outside chaff down stinging your common nettles as well. However, it breaks down in water. Matter of fact, that is one way of prepping the fibers in for stinging nettles or common nettles, is to soak them in water for a couple of days and then pull it out, get all the chaff out, let it dry out, then make your cordage. But it's not near as strong as what this is. But you can use the inner bark of many trees. Let me see. I'm getting some nice long fibers. And this piece here was only a 3 foot long off of a 3 foot tall plant. And like I said, these will get, you know, upwards of 6. See, down closer to the bottom, you get more into the woody stuff. And it becomes harder to clean out. I mean, if you're running low on fibrous material, I guess you could take the time to do that extra. But normally, this here. Trying to cut down on the amount of energy and time you're using to make anything like that, because it becomes counterproductive if you have to take too long. Alright. So, that's it for this video. I'll edit this down so that you don't have to watch my 15 minutes of just talking and talking and talking. So, alright. Thanks for watching.